Hi, I'm Nathan Lively, and today I want to show you three easy, powerful ways to phase align your main and your sub. So first of all, let me show you what we have going on here. So right now we're looking at a trace of the main. Let me show you the full thing so it's not disorienting. So here's a measurement of our main speaker. And now I'm going to zoom into the low end. This is just the lows from 0 to 200 hertz. And I'll go ahead and put our sub measurement in there, and you can see that I've already level matched these. So that would be the first step. But once I have them level matched, then I can start talking about whether or not they're in phase. So without doing anything, let's see what we have already. Now we can do this in SATlive here by opening up the live add trace. Basically what this is doing is it's summing these two traces and taking the phase down here into consideration. So if we were to turn these two speakers on together at the measurement microphone position, this is the result we would get. Okay, so now we're wondering, how good is that? What I'm gonna compare that to then is the perfect addition trace. So now this pink trace that you see here is what we would get if you didn't take phase into account. So this is the perfect addition of our main and our sub if we were perfectly phase aligned. So we can see here that this purple trace is where we are now. This pink trace is where we want to be. So, you know, we have a little ways to go here. These lines are 6 dB per division, so we have 2 or 3 dB here until we're at perfect addition. So the first way that most people learn how to do this kind of phase alignment is that they pick a frequency and then they just try to make the two pictures match. So let's do that one first. This is going to be an overlap crossover. I end up doing those a lot of times. It sounds better to me, and I in a lot of the shows and events that I work on, I think benefits us more. So that could be a whole other conversation, but for now, just be aware that we're using an overlap crossover. So then the question is, what's our region of interest? Where are we overlapping? Where are the signals really interacting with each other? And the way I set those is by seeing where we have finding our 6 dB down point with each of these traces. So we're gonna start with our main, and it's this blue trace here. So just focus on the blue trace, and as I move the cursor down, you can see that we hit the line, we go past 6 dB, and then we hit it again here. So this to me is a little bit premature, so I'm gonna call this spot 60 degrees as the 6 dB down point, because I'm kind of looking at this line trending down, right? And so I put a marker there at 60 hertz. Now the next thing I wanna do is find the 6 dB down point in my sub in the high end. So I'm gonna switch over to the sub. And now as I move the cursor up, you can watch, I hit the 6 dB down point, but again, I think that's a little premature. I'm kind of looking at what the trend is, and I think this is a better spot for that. So I'll put another marker at 120 hertz, and now we know that the region of interest here is from 60 hertz to 120 hertz. And so I put those markers in so that now when I look down here at the phase trace, it's easier to look at. So right through here, right? And pretty quickly I see that we're not phase aligned, right? So that's why our live add trace here in the purple is not all the way up to the pink. And I think, okay, I can tell here that the yellow line is farther down than the blue line, so I just need to add delay to the blue line to make these match. Luckily, I have a virtual time shift here, so I can start adding delay to the blue line to try and make it match with the yellow line. And as I do that, you can watch the purple line start to get more addition and get closer to our perfect addition trace, the pink guy. So I'm a little bit more, closer, closer, closer. That looks good. Good, and now as I add even more, you can see that I get out of phase here in the top. Oh, I'm pointing at the screen, and obviously you can't see me pointing at the screen. Up here, look how I'm not getting perfect addition anymore. If I go back a little bit, boom, looks pretty good. But if I go forward a little bit, oops, adding more delay, I'm not getting perfect addition there, but I am getting better addition down here. And so right around here is kind of the midpoint, right? Here's the midpoint of our region from 60 hertz to 120 hertz at 85 hertz. And now we match at that midpoint. And we have pretty good addition here. And so I'm thinking, though, these don't exactly match, but I have pretty good addition, so I might go ahead and run with this, right? This is what I did for a long time, is I just make the pictures match as much as I could, and then I would move on. So let's go ahead and save this live add trace to see if we can do better with another method. Okay, great. So we already have that saved. And let's reset this guy. Okay, so you might want to do this a little bit quicker. And the reason is that this goes really fast when I'm just doing it without any real audio, right? But when you're doing this in real time and you have to wait for these lines to redraw, it's not instantaneous, especially in the low end. You might have to wait a few seconds for these lines to redraw themselves every time you change the delay. So you change the delay, and then you sit there for a little bit, and then it redraws, and then you change the delay, and it redraws. So that could take a little while. It gets kind of annoying. So there's a little math here that could make this a little quicker. So if you're not afraid of a little math, then this is the piece that you need. And this information is on the back of my business card, my Aiming Triangles business card, and I'll put a link to where you can download it at the bottom of this video. So let's go through this real quick. So let me just tell you what these pieces are if you've never seen this before. So this is delta phase, and that means difference in phase, 360 degrees, and difference in frequency. So how are we going to put those numbers in there? Well, let's pick this spot, 85 hertz. Right now we are measuring, well, let's go back to this other one. So we need to measure the high phase first. So we're measuring the main, the blue, we're looking at the blue trace, and I can see it says 88 degrees here, but that's really tiny. So you can also look up here, 88 degrees. Okay. So that would be our high phase. And then we'd switch over to measuring the sub, and I can see here it says 3 degrees. And you can see up here it says 3 degrees. So what did I say? 88 and 3. Okay, so then we would subtract 3 from 88 to get our delta phase. And there's no difference in frequency because right now we're just measuring one frequency, which is 85 hertz. So then we can calculate the entire thing, and I'll show you how to do that real quick. Okay, so that would be 85 divided by 360 divided by 85, and that's going to give us the answer in seconds. So then we're going to multiply by 1,000 to get 2.7 milliseconds. And I guess if we round it up, that would actually be 2.8 milliseconds. Great. So then we didn't have to do a lot of clicking and waiting. We can just go ahead and put 2.8 into our delay line here. And then we can just check. And then if it's still not right, then we can do that calculation again, or, you know, we can push it a little bit one way or the other to make the pictures match. So those are the first two ways that I learned how to do it. One, for a long time, I just made the pictures match. And then two, I learned this piece of math that helped me do it a little bit faster. And there's a third way I'm gonna show you, which is native to SATlive. So I'm not sure if you can do it in other programs. But if you have SATlive, this will help. So we're going to use a feature called suggest delay. And the first thing we need to do is identify the region here so that SATlive knows what I'm looking for. So I'm going to select this entire region. And I only have two traces showing. Don't worry, these other live add traces are not going to be factored in. And then I click on suggest delay. Look at that. It says negative 2.9, so basically negative 3 milliseconds of delay and a polarity inversion. Number one, how do you do negative delay? Number two, inversion? That's crazy. Okay, well now I look down here. I don't know if you can see this tiny box, but I see that it's telling, SATlive is trying to tell me that it thinks that the main has a polarity inversion. Well, luckily my virtual time shift can add negative delay. So let's try that. So negative 3 milliseconds and a polarity change. Oh, that's already looking kind of better, right? It's a little bit closer matched up here than we had before. And now our live add trace looks like it's almost perfectly on top of the perfect addition trace. And we can turn on our save trace from before when I did it manually just by making the pictures match. And we can see that, again, it's a little bit better. So now this is the method I usually use in the field, because it takes, if you use the first method where you're trying to make the pictures match, it takes a little bit longer. Plus you have to try some different things. So in this case, if I wanted to find out if there was a polarity inversion, what I would need to do is I would switch from delaying the sub to delaying the main, and then I would have to hit the polarity, because you can't do negative delay in real life, right? So then I would have to hit the, switch those over, polarity invert, and I would have to save some traces so I could compare those later. And then the second method doesn't really help me that much. It just helps me do it faster. This third method, where I'm using the suggest delay feature here, lets me know that there's actually a polarity inversion involved and that I can get the phases to match even better if I polarity invert before I add that delay. So just to sum up, again, this blue trace is our main, this yellow trace is our sub, and now this green one is me doing it manually, basically. This is the addition for me doing the phase alignment manually, making the pictures match. And now this pink, I'm sorry, the purple one, which is on top of the pink, is what we got from using suggest delay. So those are three ways that I know how to do phase alignment for mains and subs. And basically I'll use whatever tool I have available at the time, whatever I think is going to be fastest and most accurate. If you have any questions about anything that I talked about today, please feel free to comment below this video, and we'll get into it.